If you want to be average, if you want to go along with the masses, my channel is not for you. If you just want to go along with the masses, I recommend you unsubscribe. My channel is for people who want the best. I recently got a message. Hey Luke, I was wondering what your opinion is about occasional usage of internet pornography. Do you still recommend going cold turkey? He goes on to make these rationalizations. Do you still recommend going up cold turkey even during the pandemic? Blah, 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 blah. All right, bro, let me put you on game here. Watching porn literally makes you a loser. And I'm not saying that in a sense of shaming. I'm saying that in the literal sense. Watching porn makes you lose your time, your energy, your focus, your vitality, your erection quality. If you're in a relationship, it makes you lose your relationship satisfaction. If you're single, it makes you lose your single and in a relationship, it makes you lose your self-esteem, your confidence. Porn makes you lose your soul and your spirit. Porn makes you lose your mind. When you're looking at thousands of girls, naked girls online, what do you think that does to your mind and psychology when you're watching a bunch of other dudes bang girls? If you went into a time machine, let's say 200 years ago, and you went to a group of men and you said, guess what, in the future, in 200 years, everyone is gonna have these screens in their pockets and screens all over their living places. And men and women, but especially men, are gonna be spending lots of their time looking at videos of other men banging women. And imagine how those ancestors would react. Those ancestors would be laughing their asses off about how pathetic modern men are. Like, and if you look around society, men are just weak nowadays. Everyone knows it. Men are really weak nowadays, and porn has got to be one of the biggest factors. I think there's a variety of factors going on, but porn's got to be one of the biggest factors, because men spend their days, and especially young men, spend their days watching screens, pixels on screens, laying in bed, watching other men bang women. If you share that to an ancestor, they wouldn't believe you. They'd be like, this is so absurd. They would think if it really was true, that would be so pathetic. That'd be like some horror nightmare that they can imagine, you know? Let me give you a history lesson. Back, not even that long ago, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, the only way to get videos of porn, you know, was to go to adult store shops. And, you know, you had to go into the shop and you had to buy this VHS tape and get porn videos through VHS tape. And guess what? It was probably less than 1% of the population that went and got these VHS tapes and looked at porn. And the stigma around it at the time was people who did that were like kind of creepy old men. It was kind of like this creepy incel-like behavior to go to this adult store shop and get these VHS tapes. However, something crazy happened in, you know, the early, as the internet started going along, and, you know, the early 2000s, when all these porn, you know, all these porn tube sites started showing up, and all of a sudden, for some reason, something that was like this stigmatized, very bizarre behavior that barely anyone partook in, it was this very weird behavior, suddenly became normalized, and suddenly the whole world and every male basically started looking at porn regularly. However, my opinion is this isn't, I feel like I'm Morpheus and, you know, you're Neo and I'm gonna wake you the fuck up. Like, just how cigarettes became normalized, it took decades of research to come out and people's experiences. People are like, why the fuck did we normalize cigarettes? That's killed so many people and it's caused so much suffering in the world. Why the fuck did we normalize that? It's the same exact thing with porn, this very weird behavior, looking at other men bang women and being this creep, suddenly became this normalized behavior that spread across the world. And now young guys are confused. They do it just because everyone else is doing it. It's like this normalized thing now. And how the, like, think about it. How the fuck did that happen? People need to wake up, wake the fuck up. I'm sure when cigarettes first started being like accepted, there were a handful of people who were being like, wait a second, this might have massive negative consequences. And they were probably laughed at and shunned. And, you know, that's how I feel regarding porn. It's like, I don't quite think people quite see the implications of how porn is just destroying society, destroying their lives, destroying their relationships, destroying their sexual health and happiness. So in my perspective, porn is not like junk food that you could have like a cheat meal every once in a while. My perspective is that porn is moral degeneracy. My perspective is that porn is poison. You lose your life force and your self-esteem, you lose your focus. There's studies that porn decreases your brain matter. So like porn literally makes you a loser in so many areas of your life. It depletes, it makes you lose your vital energy, your focus, your reward center, and just your ability to have healthy, harmonious relationships. So my man, if you want, you could go along with the masses, you could do what everyone else is doing, be average. Your life is your decision. But my strong recommendation for you is to quit porn for the rest of your life. And I guarantee you will thank me later. Winners don't look at porn. Another benefit is, for me, like the cold turkey route is actually easier as well. When you kind of start to play mind games, if you try to do some weird, like, oh, I'm gonna look at it once a week, it's still gonna be in your mind. It actually becomes harder. So it's actually easier to have a wider black perspective about it. Like the video, share this video with a friend who maybe occasionally watches porn. You know, let's wake people up. I seriously feel like Morpheus. Please subscribe. I feel like I deserve more subscribers. A big thank you to my Patreons. Comment your thoughts below. And have an excellent day. Only the best.